You see, hey, yeah, you, I'm talking to you, Rock. You see, I got those chavalitas at home, man. I got two little girls that say, and they worship the ground that their father walks on. They idolize me, man.
Those little chavalitas. I'm sure they're young.
And you see, man, the other night when I walked in the room to say goodnight for them to show their father the respect that he deserves, I saw something very disturbing. See, I looked in their wall and not only did they have a picture of me, but right next to that picture was a poster of El Rey Alacrán, the Rock.
Uh-oh. Chavalitas got a Rock poster?
Ooh, Mr. Big Shot, the movie star, man. You know what, man? In my heart, I knew I had to teach my little chavalitas, my little girls, a lesson. I had to show them discipline. So I got your poster, man, and I got it and I ripped it up and I burned it and they ran after me going, Daddy, papa, papa, por qué? Por qué? Por qué? Why? Why did you rip that poster? Shut up!
Oh, you're gonna be telling
me. Cállense!
You gotta discipline them.
A mí me respeta.
Whoa, 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 you sick psychopathic freak.
What?
Man, what the hell's the matter with you? You actually talk to your kids like that? You actually talk to your kids like that? Well, The Rock says this. You come out running your mouth. Hey, hey, you get it straight. The Rock ain't no movie star. So what? The Rock's done a couple movies, big deal. The Rock ain't no movie star. Eddie Guerrero, you are a movie star.
What?
Oh, yeah. We all know that, and The Rock will remind every single one of you. We've seen all your movies, so congratulations. A string of hits, but The Rock was always wondering, clear something up for The Rock. Who were you? Were you Cheech or Chong?
Wait a minute. Oh, boy.
I say. You know what, man? That's exactly what I'm talking about, Holmes. You don't respect no one, you know what, man? The reality, man, you're jealous. You're jealous of me, man.
Wait a minute. He is Latino heat.
You know what, man? See, you know, and all these gabachos know that I'm the better wrestler, Holmes.
The gabachos know it.
I'm more good looking. The people's champion. What a lesson. Hey, man, let me tell you something, man. I got the hottest haircut going on in America today, man. Nobody can wear the mullet like I do. I mean, come on, man. This should be called the people's mullet.
The mullet? People's mullet.
The hottest haircut in America. The hottest haircut in America should be called the people's mullet. Well, let The Rock say this. With a haircut like that and a face like that, it looks like Billy Ray Cyrus went ahead and had sex with a retarded hyena.
What? Oh, he's getting heat with Latino heat now. You can't say something like that. Rock, come on. Little chavalitos can't like this.
You're funny, man. Oh, man, you're real funny, man. You know what, I'm tired of getting disrespected. Tonight, just like I taught my kids a lesson in respecting their father, I'm gonna teach you a lesson in how to respect me. And it starts tonight, Órale, man. In that ring, me and you, mano a mano. And I'll tell you what, Holmes, if and when I kick your ass and beat you, let's say, how about you give me a shot at your WWE Campeonato.
Yeah, championship. I'll translate.
Challenge made.
Want a shot at The Rock tonight? You beat The Rock tonight, then you go on next week and get a shot at The Rock's WWE Undisputed Championship. I tell you what, The Rock doesn't speak Spanish all that well, but let The Rock tell you in a way that maybe you'll understand. It goes like this. Eddie Guerrero.
Uh-oh.
You want a shot at the great one, but there's only one problem, is you never told him whether you will cheat or whether you will chong. Ay, arriba, ay, arriba.
Continually getting disrespected.
Oh, yeah, whoa, no, The Rock ain't done. The Rock got some more. It goes like this. Guerrero and The Rock in this ring will meet, and when it's all over, The Rock whooping ass on Latino heat. Ay, arriba, ay, arriba.
Orale.
Ay, arriba, ay, arriba.
Ese voto.
Ay, arriba, ay, arriba. Eddie Guerrero.
Right, man, I'm gonna kick your ass, Ese.
Tell you what, The Rock says this.
Oh, boy.
Eddie Guerrero, all joking aside, The Rock knows you're one big bad cat. The Rock knows you can go and you can bring it. So The Rock says this. The Rock will tell you what he plans on doing tonight. The Rock plans on Leas Los Macedanos on your candy culo. And if you don't understand what The Rock just said, if he doesn't understand what The Rock just said, The Rock just said this. Tonight, live on Raw, he's gonna whoop your candy ass. If you somehow what The Rock is cooking.
So the match is on. A great one, The Rock, Eddie Guerrero, the King. What a main event that's gonna be here tonight.
Eddie Guerrero sharpens his daughter's Scorpion King poster. This is going to be great.
The great one. Certainly not wasting a lot of time in accepting the challenge of Eddie Guerrero.
Oh, andale, andale.
And what should be an awesome first meeting between Guerrero and The Rock here tonight live.
Arriba! Latino Heat!
Wait a minute.
Oh, no.
The Singapore King match with Brock Lesnar and Tommy Dreamer is upon us, but...
Look at this! He paid absolutely no attention to The Rock!
I think you're seeing an illustration, King, of some mind games by Brock Lesnar. Remember, Lesnar will meet The Rock at SummerSlam next month in the Nassau Coliseum, Uniondale, Long Island. And The Rock, I think, well, I can't read his mind, but I would think of the mind games.
Tommy, you better get a chain.
DDT, big upset here, and Dreamer. Tommy Dreamer got a long two count on Brock Lesnar, and that would have been perhaps the biggest upset that we've ever seen here on Raw.
And here we go.
Has retrieved that Singapore cane.
Finally. He eats a lot of things. I thought he ate a bowl of Skittles for breakfast this morning. Oh, no, maybe he did.
Lesnar just blocked it, and Brock Lesnar. Lesnar with the F5, and Lesnar wins the Singapore King match, and then we'll use the King.
Here is your winner, Brock Lesnar.
Hey, wait a minute.
Brock Lesnar on his way to SummerSlam.
Look at this.
Hey, wait a minute, The Undertaker. Oh. The Undertaker using Lesnar's own King on the next big thing. And that's a little payback from last week when Lesnar F5'd The Undertaker. The Undertaker taking care of Lesnar, and Heyman getting Lesnar the hell out of here.
Look at that whelp on Lesnar's head. Look at this.
The Rock bottom and El Guerrero using the X speed and quickness advantage. The Rock is reeling here. Guerrero going up. And things are Rock over that top rope, driving the air out of The Rock.
I've never seen anything.
Guerrero going up. Rock's face time. Guerrero hits this. It's over.
There he goes. He missed The Rock.
Guerrero looking for the frog splash, but he got canvas instead, and has taken the air out of Guerrero. The Rock now has the second lease on lock.
Uh-oh. Watch it, Eddie. Here you go.
And The Rock, a spine on the pine by The Rock.
Uh-oh.
and the undisputed champion now has reasserted himself.
Here it is, Dale. The most electrifying move. It's Sports Entertainment Today. People's elbow.
Putting his hands on the undisputed championship belt.
Lesnar and Rock, we know, will meet at SummerSlam for the undisputed title.
Oh my gosh.
And the next big thing.
They're meeting right here, right now, they are.
Next big thing's got his hands on the Rock's property. And these two men will collide in one of the most eagerly anticipated matchups that I can ever remember. What a SummerSlam it's gonna be!
I think this could just be more mind games on the part of Lesnar. Look at him, Rock's ready to go.
Lesnar with a gleam in his eye. What's he gonna do here? Will this thing explode in our faces?
Look at Lesnar, he keep looking down at the belt, look back up at Rock. What is this all about?
I think he wants the Rock to look down the belt.
Look at Rock's fist. He's ready to go.
Rock knows he's in a tough spot here, and Lesnar looking at the undisputed title belt, looking in the eyes of The Rock, and now Lesnar.
He's offering Rock.
Oh, that's a little disrespectful in my view. That undisputed title should never be treated like that. Thrown at the feet of The Rock in total disrespect.
Mind games.
Lesnar with his mind games is right. And is The Rock gonna buy it? Did it get in The Rock's head? Because The Rock knows the inevitable is coming at SummerSlam. The Rock and the next big thing will go one-on-one. And the undisputed championship will be decided. You can start counting the days until SummerSlam.
Look at the look on The Rock's face. He wants some of Lesnar. He's not intimidated by the next big thing. Rock is the big thing right now. He is the undisputed WWE champion.
And the fans here love it, but The Rock knows there's rough roads ahead. The Rock and Lesnar at SummerSlam. But you gotta wonder what could happen next week between them and Greensboro.
What a night this is. Hey.
Well, Steph, what are you here to get a wrestling lesson? You wanna learn how to produce sports entertainment? Or are you here to slap my face, Steph, huh?
Eric. I'm not here to slap your face. I'm here to kick you in your testicles.
Oh, really? You're gonna kick me in the testicles, Seth? Well, why don't you come out and do it?
Come on.
Come on.
You want me to do it?
Come on.
All right, I'll do it.
Oh, come on. Come on. She's gonna kick me in my testicles, Brock. Help me! Help me! She's gonna kick me in my testicles!
Okay, Eric. Okay. I will. After you, Brock. Paul.
The hell is this? What the hell are you doing? Get out of that car!
Eric, no, excuse me. Tell me, since I don't have any, how does it feel to get kicked in your testicles?
Get out of that car!
If you want to see the next big thing, you can watch SmackDown this Thursday night.
You get out of that car. You get out of that car. Get out of the car! I will knock you! I will knock you out! I will not! Get out of that car! Rock, I will knock you out! I will knock you out!
And a big clothesline! Cut angle, off with the pass, and another one!
Indianapolis showed no respect for a true American hero.
We are in America's heartland.
Oh, what a forearm shiver by Angle!
And walks right into Mark Henry.
No!
Slam by Henry! That could be it! It could be a huge upset tonight on SmackDown, but Mark Henry taking way too much. much time. Should have capitalized.
You get a guy like Angle on the mat like that, you got to go.
The splash in the corner, and Kurt Angle may be out. What an upset this would be for Mark Henry.
It ain't going to be no upset if
I hit it. The next big thing, Brock Lesnar. What the hell is Lesnar doing in there?
Lesnar just in front of
himself. Oh, my God. God. Look at this.
Brock Lesnar on SmackDown.
Impactful right out of the box. An immediate impact for the newest recruit of SmackDown. The next big thing, Brock Lesnar.
Why the hell was he out here in Angle's match?
Well, Kurt Angle would like to know. Kurt Angle not too happy. I don't think he appreciated it.
Well, Angle's in hot pursuit of the next big thing.
You just heard Kurt Angle say, what the hell are you doing? Brock Lesnar came into the ring, look, and check this out.
F5, ladies and gentlemen. Look at the power. Look at that. 353 pounds.
Brock Lesnar had Mark Henry on his shoulders to deliver the F5. And look at the look on Paul Heyman's face.
Paul Heyman slammed himself up the ramp. Brock made a hell of an impact right here on SmackDown.
I think Mark Henry knew what hit him.
What's going on here?
Hey, Brock. What the hell are you doing? What the hell was that?
Hey, I'll tell you what that was.
Paul, I'll handle this. Kurt, relax. You look like you were in trouble, so I figured I'd help you out.
Whoa, help me out? You help me out? Who the hell do you think you are?
I'm the guy that's going to SummerSlam to face The Rock for the WWE title. You see, Kurt, I was hoping I'd be able to face you. But you blew it. Maybe the pressure of always being number one is getting to you, Kurt. Well, not anymore. Now I'm here. And you, on SmackDown, being the number one guy, it's over.
Like Angle was gonna explode.
That was great.
The crowd is electric, and Hulk of the Rock is feeding off the crowd. And here comes the Hulkster. Just hitting off the tag. Here comes Hogan. Hogan delivering right hands. And The Rock, right hand of his own. And here comes the Brahma Bull. Rock bottom! Rock bottom to storm! Here's Tess into the ring! And The Rock will lay in the SmackDown!
Here goes Tess out of the ring!
Tess bouncing up, get out table, but inside the ring, Christian delivers the unprettier, the cover on Hulk Hogan! Dan Hogan kicks out!
The Hulk's just hooking up!
Listen to this place! The Rock visit with Test outside the ring! It's Hogan! Hogan begins to build momentum!
He's feeding off Indianapolis Cole! The Hulk's just feeding off the Hulkamaniacs!
Right hand! And another one! Hogan hell-bent on winning the tag titles! Boom to Christian!
ticking away at Chris Jericho, because tonight, Edge gets Jericho inside an unforgiving steel cage.
Someone's gonna bleed, someone's gonna get hurt, and I'm digging it, and so should you.
Just get out of here. Why you dinner?
Well, aren't you gonna open the door?
No, I'm sorry, this car is for someone else to see.
No, it's okay, it's okay. Stephanie said we could take her car. Everything's okay.
No, this is Hulk Hogan's car tonight.
Hulk Hogan's car?
Hulk Hogan's car.
Well, you got it all wrong. This is the next big things car, and if you don't open this door and drive for me, I'm gonna beat your ass. So open the door!
Thank you.
Now drive!
How come my agent don't get me no limos?
You know, Coach, let The Rock start off by saying this. After years of being interviewed by all these sick freaks around here, from that ugly hermaphrodite Kevin Kelly to that new guy on SmackDown, that masturbating Mark Lloyd, I tell you what, every time he interviews The Rock, he runs into a dark room, he loses 5 pounds the hard way, if you know what I'm saying. So The Rock just wants to say it's good to be here live on Raw being interviewed finally by someone normal.
Well, Rock, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Hey, it's no problem. You got to thank The Rock. I mean, you're always professional. You're always prepared, with the exception of that one time you spent the night with the cows. Other than that, you're a stand-up guy. So now, you want to ask The Rock.
Whoa. Rock. What do you mean with the exception of the night with the cows? What does that mean? What are you talking about?
Coach, don't pretend like you don't know what The Rock is talking about. You know damn well what The Rock is talking about. You and the night with the cows. Coach, live TV, let's move on. So you want to ask The Rock about SmackDown?
Rock. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, you have no idea what The Rock is talking about?
No.
You want The Rock to put you out there on Front Street? You want The Rock to do that? Huh? Is that what you want? Coach, let The Rock break it down. Since you want to admit it, let The Rock break it down. The Rock knows you come from Kansas. The Rock knows you live on a small farm in Kansas. And The Rock knows you like to go home every once in a while, drink that boon juice, moonshine, white lightning, whoa! Get a little tipsy, don't you, Coach? Yeah, The Rock knows that, and The Rock also knows you get a little tipsy, tip the bottle, and you like to spend time with the animals. One animal in particular The Rock knows about is your special cow, Bessie. Oh, The Rock knows about Bessie, what you like to do with Bessie and the microphone.
I'm afraid I don't follow.
You don't follow? Well, how about you follow this? One night, out in Kansas, in the middle of the farm.
Hey, Bessie, how you doing? Joe Powell, the coach.
Now's that ringing bell to you, Coach? So why don't you just admit it? The Rock knows you like sticking microphones up cows' rectums. Don't you?
Rock, it was just one night. It was just one night. I was drunk. You know how.
Whoa. You just admit that? You do like sticking microphones up cows' rectums? The Rock was kidding. I was joking. And now you admit that? What's the matter with you, you sick freak? What's wrong with you?
Oh, damn. Look at that cow over there.
Where?
Right there. You sick freak! Now, moving on to more serious matters. The Rock has got two things to talk about. Two things! And the first thing is the next big thing, Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar, you want to play mind games with The Rock? Is that what you want to do? Well, The Rock will tell you this. Why? Because you want to ignore The Rock on Raw? You want to throw The Rock's title down at his feet? You want to beat up on Hulk Hogan on SmackDown? Well, see, Brock Lesnar, The Rock doesn't play games, but The Rock will make one exception for you. Oh, he's gonna play a game. It's not pin the tail on the donkey. No, it's not sticking microphones up cows' rectums. No, the one game is simple, and it's called Just Bring it! So Brock Lesnar, you want The Rock at SummerSlam? Well, you got The Rock at SummerSlam. But if you want a piece of The Rock before that, it's real simple. The Rock will bring the whooping, you bring that candy ass. Now, on to tonight. For the first time ever, first time, one-on-one, The Rock, the People's Champ, against the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. You would ask The Rock a year ago, Rock, you think in 1 year you're going to be wrestling, taking on two of the biggest legends of all time, Hulk Hogan and Ric Flair. The Rock would have said, you're crazy. But not now, because finally, tonight, one-on-one, The Rock, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, right smack down in the middle of Ric Flair country, right smack down in the middle of North Carolina. One-on-one. The jet flying, limousine riding, wheeling, dealing, kiss stealing, son of a gun, Ric Flair. Oh yeah, taking on the trailblazing, eyebrow raising, jabroni beating, wow, pie eating, heart stomping, elbow dropping, People's Champ, The Rock. There's only one word to describe a matchup of this magnitude. One word to describe its enormity. One word, The Rock, Ric Flair, simply this. Woo! Nature Boy, The Rock has been waiting all of his life for this night. It's gonna be a classic. If you smell what The Rock.
Classic indeed, The Rock and the Nature Boy. We're gonna see it. We're gonna see it live as it happens here tonight.
Hey, hey, hey. Oh, no, wait a minute. He's trying to stop JR.
A lot of respect.
Something tells me he ain't done.
It's going to be an awesome match, and we got it live.
With that could be.
competition. Look at Ric Flair raising the Rock's hand from perhaps the greatest champion in the odds of many of all time, Ric Flair, to the man, the undisputed champion, The Rock. A competitive, respectful main event. How refreshing is that for once? But now what? The Rock building momentum on his way to SummerSlam, and now the announcer.
Flair's got that mic.
Lesnar's agent.
I don't think Brock Lesnar has ever met a man with the power of a Mark Henry.
Look at Heyman. He's nervous, concerned. That's his meal ticket. Lesnar's Heyman's meal ticket.
Of course he's nervous. And look at Mark Henry. And a rake in the eyes by Lesnar.
Use your brain. That's it. Next big thing. Rake in the eyes of the world's strongest man.
Oh, look at check look this at Brock out. Lesnar. Oh, no! Belly to belly throw by Lesnar.
How the hell did he do an over-the-head belly-to-belly to Mark Henry?
350 pounds.
Five-inch carry. It's going to be a five-time call.
Look at this. Five. Face first goes Henry. Brock Lesnar into the cover. And the next big thing.
Good night,
and
Henry.
A big win.
That was impressive,
here's your
man.
Winner, the next big thing, Brock Lesnar.
Big-time impressive stuff by Lesnar. F5 on Mark Henry. Like he was a featherweight.
Brock Lesnar, who has a date with The Rock at SummerSlam for the undisputed title.
Do you realize Kurt Angle and Hulk Hogan are going to fight tonight just to get a chance to wrestle Brock Lesnar next week on SmackDown?
And that sign puts it
you
correct.
Ain't lying. Danger.
The F5 is all danger.
And with Heyman in Lesnar's ear, along with that F5 and the credentials of Brock Lesnar, that spells trouble for anybody who faces the next big thing.
Well, take another look. Check out the power of Brock Lesnar. This is 353 pounds.
Lesnar flat, popping the hips with that big belly-to-belly overhead, and then hit 5 minutes carry right into this beautiful F5. Look at that.
Brock Lesnar with a statement tonight.
That moniker, the next big thing, fits that man perfectly.
The world's strongest man floored by the next big thing.
And meet the next undisputed champion, the next big thing, Brock Lesnar.
This ought to be good too.
You know, I just want to let you know, I hope you beat Kurt Angle tonight. Because I really, really want to face the Hulkster next week on SmackDown. Good luck tonight, brother.
Damn.
Very confident.
Hey, Kurt. I've been looking for you, little buddy. You see, I just want to let you know. I hope you win tonight, Kurt. Because it's you I want to face next week on SmackDown. Good luck tonight, Kurt.
Kurt Angle versus Hulk Hogan next. The winner gets Brock next week. But has the damage been done?
Accidentally, Angle dropping the referee. There's an opportunity to grab a steel chair, Kurt.
Steel chair. Frustration building that Hogan would not tap to the ankle lock.
The referee's down. Angle's got a steel chair.
And a bullet chair off the skull.
Backfire.
Off the skull.
Backfire.
Hogan off the ropes. Leg drop. The leg drop. Hogan's got him into the cover. One. There's no referee. Two. Three. Hogan should be facing Lesnar.
You can
rest down.
You can count forever. It don't matter. Referee's in La La Land.
Oh, my God. Look at this.
Lesnar.
It's Brock Lesnar. The apron, but knocked off by Hogan. Steel chair to the back. The referee saw it. Kurt Angle caught red-handed with a steel chair.
The winner of this match is a result of a disqualification. Hogan.
actually caught him with the steel chair.
Kurt Angle was caught red-handed. So Hogan will meet Lesnar next week from Richmond on SmackDown.
Angle was busted. The ref busted him with the chair. Can't believe it. Next week, Big Time Rocket Buster, Lesnar and Hogan on SmackDown.
And look at the look in the eyes of, and look at Kurt Angle. An irate, sore loser.
They're not going to lose now, but it is the Hulkster. Hook it up.
The right hand's having no effect. Hogan knows he gets Lesnar next week, but I think he wants some more of Angle here tonight.
Hogan get the energy from
boot to the face.
Here comes that big old leg drop.
Oh. Brock Lesnar grabbing the ankle of Hogan.
Come on, Hogan.
And now the next big thing.
Previewing next week, Cole, right here.
Oh, not again. Lesnar.
F5.
Brock Lesnar for the second straight week. And F5 to Hollywood Hulk Hogan.
Brock Lesnar, the next big thing, along with Paul Heyman. Sending a message to Hollywood Hulk Hogan for next week on SmackDown.
Look at that sick, demented Paul Heyman. Next week in Richmond, Brock Lesnar and Hollywood Hulk Hogan go one-on-one. And will this be the fate for the third week in a row of the legendary Hollywood Hulk Hogan?
Right here, this big F5. Listen to it. Right there. I don't know, Hogan. He gets one more of those F5 next week. You might see the winner right there, that match. Lesnar might take out Hogan on SmackDown.
Cena. It was basically a 3-on-1 assault with Rico, Chuck, and Billy on John Cena. But folks, coming up next, in a main event set up earlier tonight by SmackDown's general manager, Stephanie McMahon, it is the undisputed champion, The Rock, against the rising superstar, Edge. And Edge has been on a major roll.
Edge and Rock, it's not like these guys ain't friends and whatnot, but this is a competition.
I don't believe this.
Me neither.
I don't believe this. That's the general manager of Raw, Eric Bischoff. He was kicked out of the building earlier on by Stephanie. What the hell's he doing back here?
The testicles on this guy, unbelievable.
Bischoff has a ticket in his hand, and well, yeah, I think he just upgraded to the front row.
A good man.
Well, Bischoff's real good at spending other people's money. He's got a history of that.
But why is Bischoff here?
Obviously, he's here to see a quality show.
We are back on SmackDown, and a sickening stench is seeped into this building. That's Raw General Manager Eric Bischoff. He's in the front row, but why is that SOB here?
The following contest.
Well, we were getting set for The Rock and Edge, but this is Bischoff's SmackDown counterpart, the General Manager, Stephanie McMahon. And, well, she had her eyes trained on Bischoff as she walked down the ramp.
How crazy can you be? Eric, look at that smirk on. I'd have to knock his teeth right out of his mouth, boy. I'm telling you, man. Just an SOB.
He was thrown out earlier, Bischoff was, by security. He bought a ticket to come back to the show. Why is he here on SmackDown? And look at this ass.
I don't even know what to say. I know what I want to do, but I don't know what I want to say. And the nerve for him to say that Stephanie had nice peaches. No respect.
Tonight. Oh, I'm sorry. Is that you? Is that Eric Bischoff? The general manager of Raw? The very man that I kicked out of my arena earlier? Eric, that is very clever that you came down and you purchased your own ticket. Let's give it up for Eric. I mean, really, he's such a hell of a guy. Now, Eric, I might have confused you earlier, and obviously I confused our ring announcer, but tonight's main event is not Edge versus The Rock. Rather, it is the team of Edge and Rock facing my newly acquired Raw talent. Ladies and gentlemen, Latino Heat, Eddie Guerrero, and the new Intercontinental Champion, Chris Benoit!
What a coup for Stephanie! Benoit and Guerrero! Bischoff is livid! Good job, Stephanie! Way to stick it to him! He's in shock! We got the Intercontinental Champion called Chris Benoit! We've got Latino Heat Eddie Guerrero! Also, shocking everybody! And Bischoff is boiling! Bischoff looks like he's not one but two ghosts!
Look at the look Benoit gave him! Like, screw you, man!
Bischoff stewing! Two of Bischoff's brightest stars have defected to SmackDown.
And don't think the first time Benoit Guerrero walked out on that man, Eric Bischoff. This time it's even better.
He's lost his mind. He's nuts.
Get that man out of my building! Get him!
Eric Bischoff has lost it.
Who loses now, Bischoff?
You out! Bischoff's gonna miss out on a hell of a main event set up by Stephanie. It's Benoit Guerrero versus Edge and The Rock next. Starbuster. Watch Guerrero. The Rock is all fired up, and now he stalks Chris Benoit.
The Rock is just begging Benoit to get up to even the rock bottom. Want Benoit to get up.
Oh, look at this. Brock Lesnar with a steel chair. And The Rock sees him. It's Benoit from behind.
Cross face.
A cross face locked in. The Rock momentarily distracted by Lesnar. And the cross face locked in.
No
Will
way.
The Rock tap out?
There is no way to get out of this hole. Now look at The Rock's eyes. The Rock spots Lesnar. The Rock spots the next big thing.
The Rock saying, the hell with you. I won't tap, Brock. I won't tap.
Look at Lesnar. Just looking at The Rock, digging at The Rock. He's just hooked in that crossface.
But Benoit with that crossface hooked in. The Rock in the middle of the ring, so far away from the ropes. The pressure from Benoit.
No way out. The Rock is contemplating tapping. You can see his hand.
And The Rock taps out. The Rock had no choice to tap out.
He tapped. Benoit Guerrero with it. Rock had no choice.
Here are your winners, Chris Benoit and Eddie Guerrero.
Chris Benoit makes the undisputed champion tap out to the crossface. But it was the distraction of that man, Brock Lesnar, who beats The Rock in SummerSlam that cost Rock and Edge this tag team
matchup. And you know The Rock is going to come out like a madman at SummerSlam. He's going to want to tear Brock limb from limb.
It's Brock Lesnar and The Rock for the undisputed title at SummerSlam. It's Hogan with a steel chair to Lesnar.
That's revenge by the Hulkster for the F5s.
Hogan with a steel chair to Brock Lesnar. My God, what's it going to be like next week?
No!
Hulk Hogan versus Brock Lesnar only on SmackDown.
So, you really want to go through with this, huh? End your career tonight. Lay it all on the line. Get in the ring with the next big thing. The guy that's going to SummerSlam for the WWE title, huh? Step in the ring toe-to-toe with Brock Lesnar? Is that what you want?
You're so young. Full of life. You got the world in the palm of your hand. No injuries, man. You got it made. But if I was you, I would lay it all on the line. I would put it all up for grabs. I'd prove the point you're trying to prove. If I was you, I would put my shot at the WWE title at SummerSlam. I'd put it on the line tonight. I would put that on the line if I was you. But then again, you're not Hulk Hogan, are you?
That's what you want, huh? That's what you have. Yeah, let's do it tonight.
What the hell did you just do? Do you realize? Do you realize what you just did? What? 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 Are you out of your mind? Do you know who that man is? That is Hulk Hogan. 20 years of defying the odds. Don't think of this guy as the guy that slammed Andre the Giant. Think of him as the legend that beat Triple H for the title just a few months ago. He always overcomes adversity. That's his whole MO. He played you. You got suckered.
What's the matter, Paul? You losing confidence in me? Huh? What's the matter? You scared?
Can't believe this.
Damn it.
Yes.
Stephanie McMahon.
Paul, have you seen Dawn Marie?
Excuse me?
I have some papers that are very time sensitive and, you know, I just haven't seen Dawn anywhere. It's urgent.
I haven't seen her, but if I do, I'll send her right into you. But while I have you for a moment, I was just thinking, you know, I don't know if you heard the big news, and Brock Lesnar, the next big thing, walked into Hulk Hogan's locker room, and Hogan, you know how Hogan likes to stir everything up, challenged Brock to put the SummerSlam title shot on the line. And
I know, Paul. I thought it was a great idea.
Oh, sure. I mean, for Hogan it was. I mean, just to stir the pot and really get underneath Brock's skin and really get him all aggravated
well,
for the...
Actually, I mean, I thought it was a stroke of genius on your part and Brock's part because, I mean, if you look at the SummerSlam main event, it's either Brock versus Rock... or Rock versus Hogan, part two. I mean, really, it's a win-win all around for SmackDown. I'm so happy you came to me. You know, I really want to make that stipulation legally binding. You're on. Thank you. Now, please do send Dawn in here.
Thank you, Ms. McMahon. You know, you're getting to be more like your father every day.
The blood trickling from the mouth of Hogan.
Hogan's busted up on the inside. He's getting the life squeezed out of him.
The arm goes down that time. You say pretty, man. The arm down a second time. If it goes down a third time,
he is
over. It's over.
Hollywood Hulk Hogan can't continue. This monster has squeezed the life out of Hulk Hogan.
Let go, Brock. You got your shot at SummerSlam.
Here's your winner of the next big thing.
Let go of him, damn it! Hogan is hurt! And look at that thick Paul Heyman shouting instructions in Lesnar.
Heyman will get him off. Heyman will get Brock off. I think Heyman wants to celebrate the fact that Lesnar's going to SummerSlam to meet The Rock for the Undisputed title.
This Brock Lesnar is focused, primed, pumped, and ready for The Rock at SummerSlam.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, just a few minutes ago, there you see the next big thing, Brock Lesnar.
What?
And his agent, Paul Heyman. They joined us here in Seattle. They're sitting at ringside
Why?
Now.
Why? What's up with this? They're not supposed to be here. They're SmackDown talent.
Well, obviously, they have bought a ticket because Heyman carrying his ticket stubs for he and the next big thing, Brock Lesnar. We know that The Rock, the Undisputed Champion, is going to be here tonight. And King, I am a little unsettled. Look at that Hulkamania, well, sir. This man destroyed Hulkamania last week on SmackDown.
Heyman ought to be on America's Most Unwanted. We don't need him here.
Thank you.
they do have tickets. They're not supposed to be on my show. Stephanie McMahon is behind this. Do you understand that? Well, understand this. If either one of those two screw up this much, I want them both thrown out of my building. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Good.
John, at SummerSlam.
If you smile.
Oh, wait a minute. What? What is this? I don't know if Triple H was finished or not, but there is the undisputed WWE champion. The Rock is rocking the house here in Seattle. The Rock on his way to SummerSlam to meet the next big thing for the undisputed championship. We're less than 2 weeks away. The roof just blew off the building when the Rock stepped in here. There was a noise and it sounded like the kingdom imploding.
See that look on Lesnar's face?
Lesnar's an animal.
Finally! Lesnar, you want to play games with The Rock? You think you want to play mind games? Is that what you want to do? You think you're real smart, Brock Lesnar? Why? Because you came down here and you brought yourself a front row ticket, you and that big fat walrus, so he could cheer you on?
Big fat walrus?
But you see, you're real smart, Brock, because you do have a front row ticket, but you've also got another ticket, and that's to a big Brahma bull ass whooping, not yesterday. No. No, the ass whooping is not yesterday, it's not tomorrow. The Brahma Bull ass whooping is tonight.
Oh my God,
tonight?
Oh my God. Oh, we're gonna see it tonight, JR.
Whoa, hey, oh.
Uh-oh.
Who the hell you think you are? Who is The Rock? Who is The Rock? Oh, you should know who The Rock is. You interrupt The Rock, The Rock will be the guy getting that ring, tighten his shoes, and whoop your ass. Well, maybe you don't remember. You and The Rock, Triple H and The Rock. Well, The Rock, let The Rock break it down for you. The Rock, the most electrifying man in sports and entertainment. The Rock. The Rock, Brahma Bull, great one, people's champ. And oh, to say the least, The Rock is something you're not, undisputed champion, so shut up, bitch. So Brock Lesnar.
Ho, hey, ho.
You left out one thing there, superstar. You left out one important thing. You left out the fact that if you do lace up those little sneakers real tight and walk up those stairs, you're the guy that's gonna get.
Triple H thinks about this chant.
You are the guy that is gonna get everything, including his little sneakers laced up real tight. You're the guy that's gonna get his ass kicked. You walk in this ring.
Oh boy. Man, what a volatile situation. Look at The Rock. Oh, here we go. Jerry, here we go.
Oh, The Rock.
He just took that as a challenge.
Okay. So let The Rock understand this big shot. You want to go? Is that what you want to do, Triple H? You and The Rock, Triple H, one more time. Do you want to go?
I want to see it. Go, go.
I'd love to see him go.
I would love to go.
No way.
Well, then go get The Rock a bologna sandwich, because this doesn't concern you.
Ah! Oh, look out!
Oh, look out! The King and The Rock! The King and The Rock! Right hands and The Rock! Getting the upper hand now! The Undisputed Champion! Whoa! Take it down, The King! Triple H, where to go? There's Lesnar! Lesnar, the SmackDown! Next big thing! Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Look out! The King! Oh, my God! What a pedigree! What a pedigree! Where's security? Rock Lesnar distracted The Rock long enough for The King to lower the boom with that pedigree! The man that destroyed Hulkamania, Brock Lesnar, distracting The Rock, the man that Lesnar will meet at SummerSlam, just long enough for The King to deliver that pedigree. And now Lesnar and his men, his agent, are leaving.
Finally, security's escorting him out. Now Triple H is leaving.
Triple H did his damage. Oh, my God. What an electrifying start to this live broadcast.
I can assure you, JR, look at The Rock. This ain't over.
Man.
Listen, what?
Lesnar and Heyman, they're already out of the building. There's nothing I can do. They're smacked
down. Lesnar and Heyman, they left, right?
They're
you bitches left. Well, The Rock says they're fine. We'll get The Rock Triple H. The Rock wants Triple H. The Rock wants Triple H tonight.
Triple H, man, a match of that magnitude, I can't make a commitment like that. That's
you can't
huge.
Make a commitment like that.
I mean,
huge is the ass kicking that you're gonna get from The Rock. Can't make a commitment. The Rock wipes a monkey's ass with your commitment. The Rock says you find a way.
Let me see. Let me see what I can
find.
Do.
Away.
Let me see what I can do.
Now what? We're back live here.
Kevin! Kevin Dunn, what the hell was that?
It was the Un-Americans.
Not that, you moron! I'm talking about the SmackDown promo.
Oh, that was not us. That rolled in commercial break. We had nothing to do with that.
I don't want
to
hear your excuses. Commercial break. Stephanie McMahon, that bitch. I'll tell you what, she wants to promote a main event on my show. I'll promote a main event. Next week, right here on Raw, Triple H versus The Rock. That's a main event.
The next tag could be the difference maker in this match.
Yeah, that's right, Booker! Crowd, get over there! Come on, he's over there! Look at these people!
Booker T! Make the tag!
Oh,
no! Undertaker attacks the two legal men! An Undertaker beating the head out of Texas! Ooh, what a suit! The American Badass! Get him some! Coming on, America! Oh, look at this man, Buck! 6'10". 305 pounds. Oh! Oh, buddy. Oh! Great agility.
Look at
the quickness.
It's like a runaway freight train.
Yeah. Oh, look out here.
He got a ball.
The top team champion. Oh, Triple H. Triple H on top of the back of the Undertaker's head. Here comes the rope.
Oh, here we go.
Freaking
here we go.
It is a Pierce Explorer.
Get it right.
It's here on the Washington tonight. The Rock going outside. The last storm. It was behind the referee's back. The cerebral assassin knew just exactly what he was doing. The low blow to the Undertaker.
Oh, no, wait a minute.
Look at Taz. Right on the face of Taz.
He came in from nowhere. Oh, look out.
And Triple H with a running spot.
Hello.
The game. Oh, boy. Oh, the game.
at SummerSlam. But Test just put the lights out of The Undertaker. King is a shocker.
There's carnage everywhere, JR. Look at this. Shocker is not the word for it. I can't believe my eyes.
The Undertaker put down by Test, and damn right they'll meet at SummerSlam. But don't forget here, in 7 days, The Rock in the game. Oh, my God, what a SummerSlam. What a SummerSlam, and what a night.
Champion. Well, I guess saying his prayers and taking his vitamins didn't do Hulk Hogan much good against the next big thing, Brock Lesnar. Now, for those of you who were sitting there and could not bear to stand the sight of the immortal Hulk Hogan laying down on the canvas, bleeding from the mouth, gasping for breath, for his last, final breath of his miserable career at the hands of Brock Lesnar. My client and I have decided to let you watch the footage all over again. The last moments of a legendary career. Hulk Hogan tries to attack an agent, but Brock Lesnar, when it comes crashing down and it hurts inside, the F5 followed by Brock Lesnar squeezing the blood out of Hulk Hogan, and then with one swing of a chair, Brock Lesnar ended the career of Hulk Hogan. This is my favorite part. Watch this. Hulk Hogan, too much of a man to accept anybody else's help. Hulk Hogan, the Lord of the Hulkamaniacs, demands to stand on his own two feet. Hulk Hogan, a deity in WWE, an unparalleled career, achievements that will never be matched. A real American stands on his own two feet for the final time in his career. The greatest career in WWE history, which is now over. Who did this to Hulk Hogan? Who caused all this destruction? Brock Lesnar! Nobody has ever put down Hulk Hogan! Nobody has ever been man enough to end Hulk Hogan's career! Until now. Hulk Hogan met his match in Brock Lesnar. And do you know what the most insulting thing about it is? Hulk Hogan is not the ultimate trophy on the mantle of this warrior of ultimate proportions. Oh no! Hulk Hogan was a damned stepping stone for Brock Lesnar! Hulk Hogan was treated like a legend and a common message boy by Brock Lesnar. Because better than a letter, better than a phone call, better than an email, Brock Lesnar used and exploited Hulk Hogan to send a message to The Rock. And that message to The Rock reads loud and clear like a neon sign. And the message reads as follows. The blood of Hulkamania is on Brock Lesnar's hands. Brock Lesnar's hands at SummerSlam. Just like I ended Hulk Hogan's career. I will end The Rock's title reign at SummerSlam!
Squeal! Chris Benoit says he's gonna make The Rock squeal? Well, The Rock doesn't know what squeal means. The Rock doesn't know what in the hell squeal is. What is squeal? You explain to The Rock what squeal is? Do you know what squeal is? You look like you know what squeal is. I'll tell you what The Rock wants you to do. The Rock wants you to go ahead and bend over. Go ahead and bend over. Bend over backward.
Oh, no.
Sweet cream on an ice cream sandwich. Get up. Get your goofy ass up. Man, what's wrong with you? The Rock didn't shut up. The Rock wasn't talking about bend over, bend over. The Rock was talking about bend over backwards and explain to The Rock and the audience what in the hell Chris Benoit meant, you sick freak. Shut up. Shut up! Yeah! Get out! So Chris Benoit, yeah, you damn sure did make The Rock tap. You made The Rock tap once, but you make no mistake about it. Let The Rock tell you crystal clear, there ain't no way. And The Rock means no way that The Rock is gonna tap twice. So Chris Benoit, The Rock, tonight, SmackDown, this coming Monday night, one more time, The Rock, Triple H, and then on to SummerSlam with Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar. You want to send a message to The Rock. You've been sending messages to The Rock. 2 weeks ago, you come out during The Rock's match sending a message to The Rock. You take out Hulk Hogan, an icon, a legend, sending a message to The Rock. Sit front row Monday night sending a message to The Rock. Well, The Rock's got a message for you. One last time, The Rock is going to tell you this message. One message specially delivered to you, Brock Lesnar. It goes like this. It's a message from The Rock that transcends the world. The entire world speaking the Rock language. The Rock will tell you in all languages. Right here in German, Das Wien Zankastin. And if you don't understand that, Brock Lesnar and that big fat walrus who's cheering you on, here it is in Chinese, Ding Baka Wong. And if you didn't understand that, you damn sure will understand this. Good old fashioned American way, USA, just bring it.
It's gonna be!
Batista and The Rock bang heads.
He's the most electrifying man in sports and entertainment today. The Great One, the People's Champ, a movie star, the undisputed WWE Champion. You'd think with a resume like that, The Rock might take some things for granted. Well, as my very dear, close, personal, longtime friend John Big Gaborik said recently when asked to go out on a date with Anna Nicole Smith, not in a million years. The Rock knows better than anyone how much effort it takes to get to the top of his profession. And no one, and The Rock means no one, is ever going to outwork the Great One.
All I care about is being the absolute best. From a physicality standpoint, you have got to prepare for a guy like Brock Lesnar. I take pride in being the guy with a non-stop motor and keep saying, just bring it and bring it and bring it. And now you got a guy in Brock Lesnar who has that same mentality. He comes from that same mold of being an athlete. You really have to concentrate more on speed, quickness, and agility and power all combined into one. To enhance the speed and the agility is the ropes and running the ropes and getting that speed, getting that quickness. As soon as your foot touches the ground and try it up, it's like bah, 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 boom, jumping over the hurdles. You know, the key is with this is your speed and agility is as soon as your feet touch the ground, bang, right back up, bang, right back up. Another workout that I utilize in my routine is called the shuttle drill, and it really enhances your side-to-side lateral movement. And how important that is in working in the ring is extremely important and very vital. Running the stairs at the Orange Bowl always means a lot to me. Just being there, that's like my home away from home. That was where we went to war every single week with Miami Hurricanes and just that hot-ass Miami sun. You gotta throw in the box jumps in there, and there's different levels of box jumps. You have two or three box jumps, and then finally at the end, once you're spent, you're physically drained, there's one jump that you can do. It's one of those things where you harness all your power, all your speed, all your agility into one jump, one time. Whew. Now when we move inside and I do all the weight work, a lot of it is based upon the Olympic lifts. And my favorite Olympic lift is the clean and jerk. And just that particular movement of harnessing all your strength, all your speed, and all your power in one movement, a quick snatch up, carries over into that ability that I've been able to showcase inside the ring. What you do to enhance your grip strength, which is really, really important, obviously, in the ring, to make sure when you grab onto somebody, you're not letting go, are the hand pull-ups on the towel. So what you do is you grip towels on each side, and you are basically doing your pull-ups, utilizing your grip strength, holding on the towels. I believe in speed, agility, and power all mixed together and trying to culminate all to one apex and make it happen as one. Again, all I care about is being the absolute best.
The undisputed champion. He'll meet the Triple H tonight live.
Yeah. This package, it came for you earlier today from Paul Heyman.
Package for Paul Heyman? The Rock don't want a package for Paul Heyman. What would The Rock do with a package for Paul Heyman? That's for Paul Heyman. Well, The Rock doesn't want that. Excuse The Rock 1 second. The Rock just arrived here. He's got to say this. Excuse The Rock. Finally, The Rock has come back to Norfolk. Sorry about that. The Rock just had to do that. So what would The Rock do with a package for Paul Heyman? What's in that package for Paul Heyman? What could it be? What could it be? Viagra? Ah. Twinkies? Rogaine? Oh, The Rock knows what's in there. The Rock knows what's in there. It's probably that Ass Fetish Weekly. Paul Heyman has a subscription 10 years for Paul Heyman.
Well, it's from Paul Heyman.
From Paul Heyman.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Excuse The Rock. All right, sorry about that. Where were we? Oh, from Paul Heyman to The Rock. Oh, The Rock appreciates that. I'm only playing with you, you know that. Uh-huh. I'm only messing with you. You work here?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Nikki.
Nikki? The Rock. Dwayne Johnson. It's good to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
What's wrong?
Oh,
I'm sorry. It's got a mind of its own. Easy, big fella. Easy, big fella. Damn. Sorry about that. I'm only messing with you. Thank you for this. Have a good night. I appreciate it.
Is that Hogan?
Well, Rock, the title may not be on the line tonight, but there is no doubt that the stakes are now higher as Triple H has gotten this match with you tonight as a no disqualification match.
Will you say that like The Rock is just supposed to be scared? Why, because it's a no DQ match? No DQ, well, you see, you don't understand. As The Rock and Triple H, we go way back. The Rock. The great one, the game, Triple H. Yeah, he is that damn good. Has he beaten The Rock before? You're damn right he's beaten The Rock before, but The Rock has beat Triple H even more. And we go way back. We go way back even when The Rock and Triple H were little babies. And we were in the nursery together. We were in the nursery and little baby Triple H walking up.
My diaper is that damn wet.
Little baby Rock walking up to little baby Triple H. Hey, what the hell's the matter with you, them saggy-ass diapers? Tell you what, rattle, stuck straight up his ass, wham! And then it goes back even before that, at the colonial days. The colonial days, it's sitting there, it's gonna be The Rock, it's gonna be The Rock, George Rockington, against Benedict Helmsley and The Rock. I cannot tell a lie. You are a monkey's anus. And the Constitution shoved straight up his ass, wham! And then it goes back before that, the caveman days. It's gonna be the caveman Rock, caveman Triple H, Triple H coming in. Fire, good. Caveman Rock looking at him. Hey, I tell you what, club turned sideways, stuck straight up your ass, even better, wham! You see, what you don't understand, Coach, is The Rock and Triple H. We go way back, and tonight we're not gonna disappoint. Electrifying main event. But see, so The Rock says this, for the 4,999,000th time, The Rock gonna lay the smackdown on Triple H all over North. Fuck! Go on, Coach, what?
Well, Rock, I don't wanna break
Shut your mouth, they're chanting The Rock's name.
I don't want to break your concentration with Triple H, but earlier tonight, we did receive a package from Paul Heyman that contained a videotape intended for you. You want to see it?
Videotape of Paul Heyman? The hell's the matter with you? The Rock doesn't want to see a videotape of Paul Heyman. Paul Heyman doing what? Probably laying naked on a beach, sitting there watching Brock Lesnar work out. What, is that what he's doing? Like a big fat walrus cheering on Brock. Brock, 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 Brock. Now, The Rock don't want to see that crap. Show it. You probably want to see it. Let's see Paul Heyman naked. Ooh, good God.
Rock, rumor has it, and it's just a rumor, that Brock Lesnar and Paul Heyman are somewhere in the building tonight. But once again, it's just a rumor.
Just a rumor. Just a, who are you? Joan Rivers all of a sudden? The Rock doesn't deal with gossip. The Rock deals with facts. And the fact of the matter is this. Fact. The Rock stands before you and the millions of Rock's fans, the undisputed champion. Fact, The Rock, for 1 month, has been asking Brock Lesnar, begging, pleading, Brock Lesnar, just bring it, and he has brought nothing, nothing, nothing. So the fact of the matter is this, Brock Lesnar, so until you actually bring it to The Rock, until you come correct, no half-stepping to The Rock, you'll never be known as the next big thing, but always the next big bitch.
Wow.
Fact, Brock Lesnar, The Rock is gonna say this one last time. One last time! Just bring it. If you're some
But The Rock is cooking.
Wait a minute, look at this! It wasn't a rumor!
Paul Heyman, the SmackDown Heyman. Rock Lesnar here in Norfolk.
Rock! I figured since I got the people's voicemail that I'd let you know we're out here, Rock, amongst the people, because my client Brock Lesnar and I have a very keen interest in your match with Triple H tonight. Bye-bye, Rock. See you in a moment.
What's he got to worry about now? He's got Triple H, and now Brock Lesnar at ringside.
Palms you greased, I really don't give a damn. If the thought even crosses your mind to interfere in The Rock's match, we're going to throw you out of this building faster than you can say, good night, Mr. Bischoff. Are we clear?
We've got live, folks, obviously.
Good.
Beheading Shawn Michaels. We thought Shawn Michaels was at home in San Antonio.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Look out!
Oh, The Rock right back in the game space. The Undisputed Champion. Oh, this man is face buster. And the Undisputed Champion taking it right in the face. And now the game took in The Rock.
Oh, look out!
Brock Lesnar. Lesnar attacking Shawn Michaels.
Hey, look at
Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels is fighting back.
I would like you to consider the fact because I assure you, my client, the next big thing, Brock Lesnar, is aware of these facts. He is the number one box office attraction in World Wrestling Entertainment. The biggest star in the history of SmackDown. The single most sought after commodity in Hollywood. The number one action star in Hollywood today. He's on the cover of People. They feature him on Entertainment Tonight. He is the undisputed heavyweight champion of the entire world. With a fan following that is without question second to none. Said used to apply to Hollywood Hulk Hogan. A legend, a god, an icon whose career is now dead. Dead, I might add, at the hand of the next big thing, Brock Lesnar. And while you boo Brock Lesnar because of your jealousy, and while you jeer Brock Lesnar because no one can do a damn thing about it, the fact is, just like Hulk Hogan's career is now over, the very same thing will happen to The Rock this Sunday at SummerSlam. But ladies and gentlemen, my client has a gift for you this evening, because my client wants The Rock to have just a little taste of SummerSlam. So before tonight is over, we personally guarantee you that Brock Lesnar and the People's Champ, The Rock, will collide tonight.
Oh, wow. Strong statements by Heyman. Big time promise.
Paul,
yes, sir.
You know what I smell? Do you know how I feel? Paul, I feel the same way I felt the night I fought Hulk Hogan. I'm gonna make The Rock cry like a little
Paul Heyman promises The Rock and Brock will collide tonight.
after all your talk, after all your hype, all your talk, all your hype, so far your big jacked up monkey has bought nothing. But you see, tonight will be a night like no other. No, The Rock says you didn't hear. Tonight will be a night like no other. Tonight, no Just Bring It. No sticking up your candy asses. No smell what The Rock is cooking. And quite frankly, Brock Lesnar, seeing as you flat out refuse to bring it to The Rock, well, The Rock will just have to bring it to you. Here we go. That before the night is through, The Rock and Brock will collide. Well, then The Rock says, as far as he's concerned, this night is already through.
Here we go!
Let's go, Tom!
Wait a minute! Look at Benoit! Benoit from behind! Ambushing The Rock! Like locked doors, they're all over. Look at Lesnar! Lesnar away! Like vultures and scavengers, Benoit and Guerrero beating the hell out of The Rock! And Heyman looks at the cross face! Mocking The Rock. Can you believe the temerity of Paul Heyman and Brock Lesnar?
I can see The Rock being worked on by the trainer.
Well, Benoit Guerrero took advantage of the fact that The Rock's ribs are hurting. Hey, don't work on Mondays.
Undisputed champion has to work Raw and SmackDown and SummerSlam against this man.
In my mind, I'm number one, always. I wouldn't be here if I didn't feel like I was number one. For me, I've always trained in little holes in a wall gym, and that's how I like it. It wasn't easy for me to get to town, so I just had to use my imagination. The exercise I do with the sticks is basically just a good warm-up routine, and it works your shoulders, your back, your chest, all kinds of different areas, you know, and it works on your flexibility. It's a normal gym routine, you know, to do a step-up with weights on your back or dumbbells in your hands. With a log on my back, it's kind of like, you know, me throwing another guy around, you know, 180-pound log. It works the whole body. Fighting the handbag, you know, I mean, that was just working on my hand-eye coordination and cardio. That's the only thing that's going through my mind right there is just kicking the crap out of my opponent. So I got tired of doing push-ups on the ground, you know, and so I implemented chairs into it. Me being above the ground, I could go a lot deeper, and, you know, I didn't have the ground stopping me. I'd always finish up my chest workouts with push-ups. The sit-out drill that I do is basically an amateur drill that I learned at a very young age. It works on mat quickness and speed and agility on the mat. If you got strong hips and you're quick on the mat, you're lethal. You can do a lot of different things with the rubber bands. I did normal hand movements with the rubber bands, and it just puts resistance on it. I would hold the rubber bands in and take my double leg shot, and it puts resistance on me and holding close to your hips and works on your hip speed again. For me to take ice baths, getting in that ice water, number one, it's a mental thing. The water is 35 degrees, you know. It's no different than putting an ice bag on your elbow. When you jump in the ice bath, it's your whole body. I mean, if you can sit in there for 10, 12 minutes, you know, you broke the mental stage of it, so now it's a physical thing. I'm recuperating my body, reviving my muscles for the next day of training. I'm always got the mindset of beating my opponent. Every repetition is for my opponent, you know. Get one more, you know, for him. I gotta train like a madman all year long. It makes me that much better. Outdo my opponent, always.
SummerSlam. Presented by Foot Locker. Only 3 days away. Live on pay-per-view.
Appreciate it, Larry.
Sure.
Thank you, man.
Hey, Rock. You alright?
Yeah, I'm alright. Other than Benoit putting a crippled crossface on me again, that damn Eddie Guerrero doing the Macarena all over my ribs. Other than that, I'm cool, man. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, well, they jumped me too. Benoit and Guerrero, they're out of control right now.
Out of control? They're gonna get their monkey asses whooped tonight. The Rocket.
What about SummerSlam? I mean, what about your ribs?
The Rock's ribs? The Rock's ass? The Rock's got hurt ribs. Big deal. It's no big deal at all. There is no quit in The Rock. No quit in me, my friend. No way. The Rock says this. You go ahead and take out The Rock's ribs. Fine. Take off one of The Rock's arms. He'll fight you with the other arm. You take off one of The Rock's legs. The Rock will hobble and hobble and hobble and keep hobbling and whoop the monkey ass with the other leg. Easy, big fella. Easy. Oh, yeah. You go ahead and you can take off one of The Rock's testicles, the people's testicles. Oh, yeah. The Rock will take the other one. Throw it way up in the air. Keep watching it. Damn, that's a good-ass testicle. The Rock will take his boot, shine it up real nice. Excuse The Rock. Turn that sumbitch sideways
and stick it straight up Benoit Guerrero's candy asses.
Hey, come on, man, let's go.
Edge and Guerrero meet Sunday at SummerSlam. Edge taking Guerrero and Benoit out.
Edge is bouncing. Both Guerrero and Benoit.
Edge all fired up.
Face plant.
Eddie, face first. Benoit into the corner. Oh, a shoulder to the gut.
Spear-like move. The way to go, spear.
Good for the spear. Eddie ducked out of the way.
He tried that last week. This week, Edge didn't go for it.
Eddie plants. Eddie Guerrero. Cover. Hooks the leg.
Save.
Benoit breaks up the three count.
This is 3 days before SummerSlam.
And now The Rock, the promo pull. No quit in the champion.
The Rock, Ravana!
Bottom to Chris Benoit.
All hot, The Rock. Spear. Cover, that's it. Edge and Rock win.
Edge and Rock win. Edge pins Eddie Guerrero. It's a huge win for The Rock and Edge on SmackDown. Wait a minute.
Brock Lesnar.
And The Rock has been waiting for this moment for weeks to get his hands on Brock Lesnar.
Paul Heyman said it at the top of the show. Heyman promised, The Rock and Brock Lesnar would collide.
The Rock wants Brock Lesnar to himself. The Rock cannot wait until Sunday. Watch Brock now!
Just 3 days to SummerSlam, and these two bulls ain't got the patience to wait!
And Lester's bringing it, and here we go! And Brock Lesnar immediately going for the injured ribs of The Rock, driving that shoulder into The Rock's ribs.
Lesnar just bringing that big, thick shoulder, folding The Rock in half, driving it right through his spine.
The Rock writhing in pain. The champion's in trouble. The challenger making
Lesnar.
And here comes The Rock, the people's champ, battling back. The Rock.
Spit punch.
Laying the smackdown.
Lesnar's pumped. Rock is pumped and Heyman using his brain, trying to stop Brock Lesnar. Wait till SummerSlam.
The anticipation is at a fever pitch. The Rock and Brock Lesnar collide Sunday.
We're 3 days away. Sunday can't get here quick enough.
SummerSlam!
But first up, the next big thing, Brock Lesnar. It is often said the true test of superstardom is how one performs on the big stage, in key moments, against top opponents. For the next big thing, the first big test is less than 24 hours away when he faces The Rock for the WWE Undisputed title at SummerSlam. No question, Brock is currently on the fast track to the top. But has it always been that way? Well, tonight we're going to step back in time, if you will, as we venture to Webster, South Dakota, population 2018. That's where the real story of Brock Lesnar begins. As his mom would say, he's just a farm boy. He developed his incredible work ethic by working dawn to dusk on the family's dairy farm. And as we're about to find out, Brock's aggressive nature began at an early age, and it really hasn't changed all that much. Although he has his moments, you certainly wouldn't describe Brock as warm and fuzzy. And make no mistake about it, nothing will stop him from getting what he wants.
I saw him last Thursday night, and I feel sorry for Hulk Hogan. Oh my gosh, if I'd have been closer, I'd have went and tried to help Hulk out a little bit.
That's what I used to sit in, Tony. That's when I got my first haircut in.
Oh, I've known Brock since he was, well, gosh. Do I dare to tell him?
Thank you very much.
Since you were in diapers?
You know, he was a skinny little blonde-haired kid. I don't think his arm was bigger than that around. He never did cry, though.
I never trusted too many barbers when I left Tony. And not only can Tony cut hair, he can sing pretty good, too. Ain't that right, Tony? I grew up in Webster, South Dakota, a rural farm community. Lots of grain farm. I grew up on a dairy farm.
Yeah, this is the farm I grew up on. We used to have about 200 head of cows. I left here in 1996. Used to have some good times here and some hard times.
It was just kind of backwoodsy, you know, kind of out in the country. Not a lot going on. Everybody knows everybody, and everybody knows everybody's business.
Brock Edward Lesnar. He weighed 9'9", and they called him Pork Chops. Brock was robust, on the go, inquisitive.
Very independent, very headstrong, liked to be outdoors. Even at the age of 4 and 5, he wanted to help on the farm. He was really a worker.
I was a very aggressive young kid, eager to do anything, always up for any challenges. I would always like to do the regular farm kid stuff. Some nights it would just be cool to sleep up in the hayloft. My hayloft was like my jungle gym.
You know, his name was Brock, and I used to make fun of him when I met him when he was little. I'd say, I used to call him Broccoli, and I hated broccoli. You know, when you're young, I mean, nobody likes to eat broccoli, and he'd be like, hey, Broccoli, you got bad taste, I'd say to him. And I remember he was kind of scared of me, actually, when we were little kids.
As a young kid, I was a real tall, lean, skinny kid.
The top of his legs was the same diameter as, you know, the bottom.
I was very limber and strong.
He likes showing off his muscles.
I was always active. I was always doing push-ups, always doing sit-ups, always working out as long as I can remember. I discovered sports at a very young age. My high school and little kids wrestling coach, I grew up 2 miles from him. He took me under his wing and guided me to wrestle. He saw some potential in me at a very young age. I started wrestling when I was like 5 or 6.
He was always a strength wrestler, but lots of times he didn't have the strength to wrestle that way, so he got defeated here and there. He always had a little bit of a temper and was very aggressive. From little on, we found out that he couldn't cut weight very well, because every time we had him cut weight, he didn't make weight, and he got really ornery, and so we just decided that he was going to be a big guy, and we'd keep feeding him.
Yeah, I was always hungry, always. It was like I had a tapeworm.
When he worked for me on the farm, we had 7 hired men and our own kids, and we would eat one meal, and my mother would make a separate meal for Brock, because he would eat all ours if we didn't.
I can remember going in and just having an attitude, you know. I thought I was pretty bad, still do today. I don't have many highlights as an amateur wrestler. The only thing that I can remember is people being scared to wrestle me because I was very physical. Maybe I didn't win all the time, but one thing was for sure, if you're wrestling me, you're gonna get beat up. But that's what it is, it's just one-on-one. It's basically a legal street fight with a few rules. That's what I liked about it.
I believe you gotta learn to lose before you learn to win. And Brock lost his share of matches, and he was not special coming up in the kids' ranks. Then he caught on, and once Brock gets confidence in doing something, he's unbeatable.
Growing up and going through the school were some of my goals to be a state champion. I didn't succeed in those. That's why that drove myself to get bigger, stronger, faster, and quicker on the mat, and I wanted to be a college wrestler. And I do believe if I would have won a state title, I wouldn't even be sitting here talking to you today probably, because I had some unfinished business to do. I knew that in my heart. I decided to go to Bismarck Junior College, placed fifth at the Junior College Nationals, came back the next year and won a Junior College Championship. That's when a lot of Division I schools were interested in me. Number one, I had a great physique, I was a great athlete, and I was in great condition, and I could wrestle. And there's not very many heavyweights out there that are built like me, that can go like me, and so I was a hot commodity for a couple of weeks until I decided where I was gonna wrestle. And I chose the University of Minnesota, and then when I finally went there, I hit like a loose cannon, bam, you know, I went out and I was beating people. The next thing you know, I was in the NCAA Finals. My biggest rivalry my senior year was a guy by the name of Wes Hand. He wrestled for University of Iowa.
Well, I'll tell you, that championship match was probably harder on his mother and I. My wife says, you're gonna have to go into cardiac arrest or something. I guess I was all white, you know, and just yelling and screaming.
They were so darn close throughout the whole match. And I mean, his opponent was out to get him because Brock had done him in several times.
We knew it was gonna be a big, tough match, and it got down to the double overtime.
That was the only thing that mattered to him. You know, money didn't matter to him.
It was like a big weight was lifted off of me, and I had accomplished everything. I looked up at my mom and dad in the stands, and I looked at my high school wrestling coach who was there watching me, and I just can remember that feeling of just like, man, I did it, and I finally did it.
It was a dream come true.
Here's the man going down. SummerSlam, dead meat.
I love to be center stage. I love to be physical, and it's something that my love for amateur wrestling kind of ran dry. I get the same feeling from being in the ring with professional wrestling. You know, I get that high, being out there and being in front of the people and just doing my thing.